Hey guys, it's your boy Kurt Pierce, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool Chroma, where last time I left off. He secured the league title. Now in the last episode, it's a bit hard to explain, so I'm gonna have to actually back out. I was about to enter my quarterfinal in the Champions League with Arsenal, but to explain this, I actually have to show you what happened. Now, in the last episode, excuse me, I also defeated Southampton in the quarterfinal of the FA Cup to progress to the semi-final. And when I beat Swansea 2-0, I went 21 points clear of Manchester United, because as you can see just above my result, you can see Spurs held Man United to a 1-1 draw. This result actually meant that Man United were 21 points behind me with 7 games remaining. Now, it didn't officially deem me winners of the Premier League, but Man United could not have caught me in any capacity. So I simmed the game against Hull. As you can see, Man United did beat Middlesbrough, so they're still 21 points behind, but now there's only 6 games remaining, which means the points that can be got is only 18. So even if I were to lose the rest of the games in the league, I would still win the league by at least 3 points. And of course, Man United would have to win their last 6 games. And they're not all going to be against Middlesbrough, who actually, that result actually relegated Middlesbrough. So Man United did something in their match at least. They sent Middlesbrough back to the championship. Middlesbrough fans will be hoping something like that doesn't happen in real life, because of course Middlesbrough are back now in the Premier League. They hope it's not a one in season stay. But yeah, I defeated Hull 2-0. I actually used the second team, Divock Origi and Sam Wilson got the goals, so, that's how confident I was that I'd get a win. I simmed with the second team. So, that's done. That's in the history books. I have now won 4 straight league titles as we go into a champion. He came against Arsenal. It's the first leg, and since they got a break at the weekend, and it's the first team out again, it's Arsenal to make sure I can secure that at first leg, commanding first leg victory, in the hopes that I can sim the second leg and have absolutely no worries that Arsenal might overturn the deficit and knock me out. But of course, hopefully I'll be also hoping to prevent Arsenal from scoring in any way goals, because of course, if I were to beat him 3-0 here and then they beat me 4-1. Then at the Emirates, I would go through on that one away goal. Of course, I don't need to explain the away goal rule. I'm sure most of you, if not all of you, know it very, very well, because it's pretty much affected every team at some point or another. Unless, like, you support a lower league team who normally don't have to put up with two-legged affairs. Although, There is the playoffs, but away goals don't seem to matter in those. Because I watched the playoffs this year, as I do every year. If there's some like basketball fans watching, I don't mean the NBA playoffs. I mean the like the championship and the League One and League Two. Yeah, I watched those playoffs. It's so confusing. Not that I don't watch basketball, I watch it occasionally.
I think the referee is showing how he's going to officiate this match. It's going to be a free kick. He's not going to stand any nonsense.
Why wouldn't... It wasn't letting me play on. What the hell? Royce. Of course, if you guys remember, a few episodes ago, I absolutely gave Arsenal a horrific, like, hiding. So, Arsenal will be at most looking to redeem that. Of course, this is a little prelude to the start of next year's Premier League, because of course this is the first match for my team Liverpool is an away trip to the Emirates.
Santi Cazorla attacking now. Another shot. Useful blocking.
And it will be very interesting to see how who this plays out, because
that will be Liverpool's throw in.
A common theme for teams that want to finish in the top four is you always want to get off to a good start.
Yeah, I thought he might have done better there, had a bit of time and space.
Now, over the past few seasons, Arsenal haven't gotten off to the best of starts, losing to West Ham this season and losing to Aston Villa the season beforehand. But I'm not going to count my... I'm not going to say, oh, Arsenal are going to be terrible in this first game in the past few seasons. Dictate that. That's not the case at all. If anything, Arsenal will try harder, especially against a team. They'll expect to give them a challenge, because I don't think anyone was expecting West Ham to have as good a season last season as they did. Unless, of course, you're a West Ham fan. And in which case, you would have been hoping.
The fixture for Liverpool, they'll be hosting Everton.
Yeah, it's got a good feel about it, that one. Look forward to joining you in the gantry for it.
Anyway,
pitch, but I think attacking players favour Alan, don't they?
I think they do, yeah, because it means mistakes from defenders.
Yeah, I think the
loss of footing and you're in.
My brain is saying if I had to predict what the result will be, I could see it being a draw, to be honest, because Liverpool tend
Javi Martinez.
Start out the season as they mean to go on. Or sometimes they'll start with a few wins and then they'll come into their draws. Because Liverpool love to get their old draws, but I can see it being a draw. But I'm hoping for a good match, and I think Arsenal fans will want that as well. Well, because, you know, it'd be good. Could if the first match back, if anything, we have a good match, maybe he won to remember. Who knows? Maybe it'll end 4-4 or some shit like that. Wouldn't that be crazy? Yeah, goal fests of the ages between Arsenal and Liverpool. That's happened before. Or let's remember what happened a few months ago. With that 3-3 draw.
Good first half, hoping for something better in the second half. The second half.
That's not like it's the only
Champions Cup quarter final.
He big goal fest between
the first half, but it might open up as the match wears on.
Us Reds and the Gunners.
Well, they're going to start from the back.
But pass to the keeper. The only thing for Arsenal is who will be up front for them. Because, of course, Danny Welbeck is injured, out for about 9 months, apparently. And there's some worrying reports, if you're an Arsenal fan, that Olivier Giroud might miss the start of the season. Arsenal fans are probably holding their breath like, no, do not do this.
First goal, it's 1-0.
If Olivier Giroud is injured, who's going to play up front? Will it be a youngster? Maybe one of the youngsters that Arsenal constantly send out on loan and completely forget about for the whole season? And then they use him preseason, send him out on loan again and repeat? Rinse, repeat?
Some activity down on the Arsenal bench. Now they can launch a counter-attack.
I think...
it's a neat pass.
I think if... whether Giroud is going to miss the Liverpool game or not, I think... in this season... just emphasizes more that Arsenal need to sign a striker. Which I don't need to tell Arsenal fans, because they are the ones constantly... he's shouting at Wenger to do that, and he constantly ignores them.
Hit back in this game, and they're going to try and do it with a substitute.
Seriously, you think Arsenal fans would be allowed to have more of a voice in a club of that without their fan support would be real dump. And the Emirates, if all that was in there was the contingent of away fans, like every game you just see the away fans, and all the home fans were just not there.
But they've shown a little bit of guts there to try and get in and make some inroads into this deficit.
It'd be the Emirates. No, that doesn't work.
And that tackle right on the edge.
Trying to put the words empty and Emirates together. That doesn't work as well as it does with the Etihad, does it? Oh, there's something for Arsenal fans. Their stadium can't be rebranded if ever it is completely fucking empty. Although maybe things will change if Wenger takes the England job. Although, if you ask me, he's the best candidate they're putting forward for the job. And here's why I say that. Because if England want to win a Euros or a World Cup or whatever, they need a manager who has won trophies. Sam Allardyce, what the fuck has he won? Except lower division trophy. He's a few years ago. Like,
Royce.
I mean, take frickin' hiring strategies from your
and the goalkeeper got a touch to that.
Your big clubs, like Man United signed Jose Mourinho because he has the pedigree of having won the Premier League multiple times with Chelsea. Because that's what Man United fans want. They want to win the league again. Because they've won since Alex Ferguson's left has won FA Cup. And they don't want to become the new Arsenal. Well, no offense, Arsenal, but up until your FA Cup wins recently were on a dry spell. You know that yourselves.
Well, they've widened the margin now. 3-0.
So Man United had got a proven manager a proven history of winning trophies. It's what an odd concept. Liverpool got rid of a terrible manager with no pedigree whatsoever, and brought in Jurgen Klopp, the man who somehow managed to turn Borussia Dortmund into a forgotten team, into the second best team He missed.
The defender has stranded the goalkeeper. No chance for him.
Germany.
Just a reminder, 3-1.
Okay, I'll give him credit. That was a fantastic free kick from Olivia Giroud.
Proud of this, but it won't mean too much in terms.
I didn't even know he was good at free kicks. Someone else took Arsenal's free kicks.
They put that cross far too close to the goalkeeper.
Oh well. What was I talking about? Oh yeah. Jurgen Klopp won the Bundesliga 2 years in a row. Really affecting Bayern's dominance. Instead, they're breaking the trend of their dominance. And all of a sudden, bam, out of nowhere, Liverpool are like, oh, let's get rid of this guy. He's won shit. And get this guy. He's brilliant. And he's fantastic. His character. So Liverpool bringing Jurgen Klopp. He gets a team. He had made no signings. Things except one lone signing who didn't partake in any matches, and one guy who went straight back out on loan to the team we signed him from. He pretty much made no changes to that team. It was still Brendan Rodgers' team, and yet he took that team to two cup finals. Would Brendan Rodgers have taken that team to two cup finals? Hell no! Oh, absolutely not. Manchester City. It wasn't working under Pellegrini. So who did they get? They got Pep Guardiola, a proven manager with proven title winning skill. And this is why a manager like Arsene Wenger is a really good pick for England, because he has the proven trophy winning makeup. He has won trophies before. He knows the England scene because he's the longest serving manager in the Premier League. Maybe even in all of England right now, because Ferguson is gone. I mean, if he hadn't retired, who would say that England wouldn't be ringing up Ferguson's phone? Oh, chances are they probably... He freaking tried that, knowing England. But if Arsenal... Not if Arsenal. If England realistically want to win a World Cup or a Euros, they cannot pick another manager who has no experience winning in trophies. They can't pick another Steve McClaren. They can't pick another Roy Hodgson. They can't pick another one of these corporate idiots who couldn't figure out how to beat Iceland. And when everyone was shocked that England lost to Iceland, the rest of the world was like, why are you shocked? This always happens, and you were practically writing them off. Hell, there were pundits pretty much booking the match between England and France way in advance. And anyway, considering what France did to Iceland, I'd be pretty happy if I was an England supporter about what happened between England and Iceland, because can you imagine England's response to getting that dominated by France? Considering the English don't like the French, and I don't quite blame them. As an Irish citizen, and we know what it's like to not be on good terms with the French. The rotten and cheating bastards. But to have a manager with a proven record, with the proven ability to win you trophies, is always a good option. This is why Arsene Wenger would be a good choice for England manager. And if it's not Arsene Wenger, then they should get someone with proven pedigree. Why not Laurent Blanc? He just got fired from PSG. He's won a few trophies with PSG. Why not try getting him? If you're not going to get Wenger, or get someone with proven experience winning trophies. Is because if England realistically want to win trophies, they have to get someone who knows how to win a trophy and isn't going to get beat by these teams that realistically, and no offense to Iceland, they should not have beaten England. They shouldn't have. And England fans know this. That's why they were so cocky. But the reason they were so cocky and the fact that they hadn't got a good enough manager is the whole reason that he lost to Iceland and went out of the Euros. They went out of the World Cup in the group stages. It's Euro 2012. Of every year since 1966, England have been trying to win a tournament again, and they haven't gotten the right. They had the players at one point, and who did they have at manager? Steve McClaren. Senor Eriksson. Just no one. Not good enough. And I don't understand why England cannot see that the problem is the manager. The problem is the manager. Because England had, at one point, a really good team.
Fist away by the keeper.
It is... If you do not...
Cristiano Ronaldo.
I'm sure there's...
You go back to the goalkeeper here and does.
For those of my subscribers who for some reason aren't, go watch...
Neymar.
One of the was by
he's looking for the cross.
A Newcastle supporter and fellow YouTuber, The True Jory. He will tell you exactly why Steve McClaren wasn't a good enough choice is for Newcastle, let alone England. He couldn't get the golden generation of the likes of Beckham in his prime. Gerrard in his prime, Lampard in his prime. He couldn't get those players to the Euros. He couldn't even qualify, and yet he was made Newcastle manager. And the Newcastle management and were scratching their heads. It's wondering why they got relegated. I wonder why. Not like they had a terrible manager. And I mean, if England could get relegated, they probably would get relegated from participating in Euros and World Cups. That's how bad their managerial choices have been. They're not good enough. They need proven winners. And they haven't employed proven winners. In ages, like their last proven winner. Who even was it? Who was it?
He's taking it away there with a very good tackle. Alex Oxlade-
I mean, you could pay, you could hire or Sam Allardyce, but it's not going to fix anything. England will still lose. Losing Euros and World Cups. And Sam Allardyce will get sacked. And the cycle will begin once again. And people will still scratch their head and wonder, why are England so shit?
Neymar.
It's a freaking mystery. An absolute brain-teasing mystery.
He's kept it out.
Sorry, I hit the mic there.
Well, with this two...
Whew! I did not realize how much I could talk about something I don't give a shit about.
Champions Cup quarterfinal.
Yeah, it got a little bit cagey at times in that first half, but it might open up as the match wears on.
Good forward play from them. No doubt that's a corner. Comes out with a punch to clear the danger.
Nathaniel Klein buries it in the bottom corner, or cancels out Arsenal's away goal. Oh, well, that should definitely secure my a spot in the next round of the Champions League.
Because they just didn't follow in there.
Great control. Cech is completely off his line, so Klein just has to get his shot on target. It barely is, but it's on target. To the point. And it's in. And it's 1-0. 4-1 I agree. An aggregate? An aggregate.
And it's going to be a throw here. They're on the move now.
And that should be that. Wrapped up in a nice piece. Pretty bow.
Real good contest between these two as they jostle for possession.
Like, all Arsenal can do is score four goals. They have to score four goals because if they score three and.
Really special fixture for you. The semi final FA Cup fixture.
They'll only take this extra time.
And it's just off the mark.
Well, from that distance, I thought he might have tucked it away, but...
of course, they'd have to score or four without reply.
Ricardo Rodriguez.
One more goal from me will make it next to impossible for them to win.
It's good to win the ball.
Referee! Referee! Referee, you absolute prick! How did you not see that? Like, are you completely that? Oh, but you give that foul! And he gives a yellow card! What the fuck? That is complete bullshit! He doesn't give a pretty much obvious penalty, but he gives that as a yellow card.
Across Neymar. Well, that's straight at the goalkeeper. What about Liverpool's next game?
Yeah, Bale. Chelsea in the next match in the FA Cup semi-final. I can't see them facing too many problems in this one. Easy for them. I think they could coast home in this one.
Turn man.
Well, it's a nice bit of skill.
If he whips in, can Roy send it back? Oh. It's going to come to Neymar. No, Petr Cech grabs it. Someone's offside. Probably Ronaldo. Yeah, that's where Ronaldo was. Oh, wait, Neymar. Oh, Neymar's going to be penalized for that. Really? Oh, that's a yellow card. Wow. That suspends Neymar for the first leg of the semi-final.
He is to them because he's one of the best finishers around. They don't want to lose him, that's for sure.
Oh, come on, that is complete bull.
And that ball belongs to the goalkeeper. Gareth Bale. And it'll go into the middle now.
Coutinho! Oh!
Save. Corner. The goalkeeper comes out with a punch. Bale! And
here's the Ronaldo! Oh, the blocks are real.
still 1-0 here, with the time almost up. What about this impacting on their next game?
Well, Arsenal go up against Manchester United. Really don't think they'll be happy at all. The manager, in fact, I think he's furious with them.
Catch.
Looking at my watch, 4 minutes left.
Oh, the defensive mistake. Neymar, it's over. Neymar wraps it up. Up 2-0 on the night, 5-1 on aggregate. The semi-final. Oh, here we come. Socrates and Gabriel. Oh, we're pissing around at the back, and Neymar punished them with extreme precision. And those Arsenal fans could only watch as their hopes of and dreams were crushed. Just Brazilian style, biatch!
Restarting at 2-0. Can happen in 4 minutes. That's what we've got of added time.
Can Ronaldo get a goal himself? Yes, he can. It's all over. Or just to rub it in. Cristiano Ronaldo adds yet another goal. I've now scored three in both legs. Great assist from Bale. Ronaldo does what Ronaldo does best. Scoring goals. Boom! And you can see the disappointment and the distraught in the Arsenal fans behind the goal. While the fans over there in the corner are going absolutely bonkers because another semi-final is on its way. Question is who it's against. I guess we'll find out after for the match. Oh. Not going to add another, are we? Surely not. Oh, there we go. It's offside. Which will lead to a free kick, which will probably be the last kick of this quarterfinal. No? There's the full-time whistle. Well, I am through to the semi-final. It's disappointment once again for Arsenal.
Into the semi-finals.
Yeah, and I think the opposition, the losers, can have no complaints.
Really, it was over as soon as that Nathaniel Clyde goal went in. I think Barcelona are through in that. I think they won 1-0 in the first leg. Oh no, 3-0. Excuse me. Hey, I obviously didn't see the final score, because I guess it was 1-0 at halftime. I know I saw it was 1-0 at some point. So those Chelsea-Juventus Seville-PSG games, are those over, or are we waiting on them? Because it looks like the Seville one is over anyway. Hey, damn. What the hell has Seville got? I know they have Courtois, but damn, they must have some really good striker up front for them. And to say they are banging in goals. 10-2 consecutive games? And again, I have 10-2 who knockout games as well, because I scored 4 against Anderlecht and 6 against Arsenal. Boom. Watch me compared with Seville now. That's exactly what's gonna happen, isn't it? Yeah, I know, he's suspended. You are welcome, Cristiano. Oh, next session I will go up to 71 on the FIFA ranking thing. Thingamabob. Whatever it's called. I don't understand why he thinks he's ever gonna be replaced. He's one of the stars of my team. So in the next episode, I will, and I did get Seville. I freaking called it. So in the next episode, you will see the FA Cup semifinal against Chelsea, and you will see the first leg against Seville, which is away. Chance for me to get an away goal. And if I get a big enough victory, I can zoom all the way to the finals. Way! Fantastic. So, that'll be the next episode. Thanks for watching this episode. Smash the like button if you enjoy it. Subscribe for more videos very, very soon because I have more videos planned. And keep an eye out for them. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day.